So the first question, the distance r of the block at time t is. So right now we are in the rotational frame. The block is just moving along this direction, and along this direction, the only force which is acting is m into r into omega square. So along the slot, we can write net force equals to mass into acceleration of the block. Next, cancelling out m both sides, we write a equals to r omega square. We can write the acceleration of the block as v dv by dr equals to r omega square. Next, taking this dr this side and integrating both the sides to find the value of speed of the block as a function of its distance from the center. When the block was placed at r by 2, its speed was 0. When it is at some distance r from the center, it has a speed v. We are going to find v as a function of r by performing the integration. So integral v dv is v square by 2. We substitute the lower and the upper limit. So we get v square by 2 minus 0, which is v square by 2 equals to omega square is a constant. We are taking it outside. R dr, the integration is r square by 2. Okay, so the 2 we are taking outside, and substituting the limits, we'll get r square minus r by 2 the whole square, which is r square by 4. Cancelling out the 2 here in LHS and RHS and taking a square root, we get v equals to omega under root r square minus capital R square by 4. Now we want to find r of the block as a function of time, so we write this v as dr by dt. So dr by dt equals to omega under root r square minus capital R square by 4. Now the equation is only in terms of r and t. Taking r terms to one side and time term to the other side, we get dr by under root r square minus capital R square by 4 equals to omega into dt. Next, we will integrate this expression. When time is 0, the block was placed at r by 2 from the center. We need to find what is r, the distance of the block from the center, as a function of time. So I hope you have understood the lower and the upper limits in each case. We know the integration of dr by root r square minus capital R square by 4 is ln of r plus root over r square minus capital R square by 4. So putting that here, and the lower limit and the upper limit equals to omega times integral dt is t. So omega times t here. Substituting the upper and the lower limits in the equation, we get ln r plus root over r square minus capital R square by 4 minus, when you substitute this r by 2, r by 2 whole square here and r square by 4 get cancelled, you are just left with ln of r by 2. So ln of r by 2 equals to omega into t. Next, using the formula, ln a minus ln b is ln a by b. So we get this expression equals to omega into t. Next, writing this whole expression, we can write as equal to e power omega t. So r plus root over r square minus capital R square by 4 divided by r by 2 equals to e power omega t. So I'm just taking this r by 2 this side. So we will get r plus root over r square minus capital R square by 4 equals to capital R by 2 into e power omega t. Next, we take this r to the RHS. So you can see this expression here. I'm taking it to the RHS and I'm squaring both sides. Okay, so LHS whole square equal to the RHS whole square. So squaring these both sides, we get r square minus r square by 4. Okay, it's the same, equals to, this is a minus b the whole square, that is a square. So this whole square is r square by 4 e power 2 omega t plus r square. So r square minus 2 times r by 2 e power omega t into small r. So the 2 and 2 from here get cancelled, and finally we get this expression. We are simplifying the expression further and cancelling r both sides, LHS and RHS, and then we get this expression. Now we take this term e power omega t to this side, okay. So this expression divided by e power omega t, we will get e power omega t plus r by 4 divided by e power omega t. I'm writing it as r by 4 into e power minus omega t. So finally, taking r by 4 common, we get r equals to r by 4 into e power omega t plus e power minus omega t. So this is the final answer to our question: what is the distance r of the block at time t? The next question is to find the net reaction of the disc on the block. So here he is talking about the normal reaction. The normal reaction on this block is due to the base of the slot and due to the contact with the side wall here. In the question, he had mentioned that this direction is J cap and this direction is K cap. As the block is not moving in this direction, okay, so we can write the net force in this direction is zero. So we are writing N1 minus Mg equals to zero, or N1 equals to M into G. Next, when we are looking at the block in a rotational reference frame, we see that the block is only moving along the slot, and perpendicular to the slot, it is not moving. So we can equate these two forces, N2 and 2m omega into V. So the net force perpendicular to the slot is zero. So we are writing N2 minus 2m omega into V equals to zero. In the first question, we had got the value of R, and the V rotational is nothing but dr by dt. So we can calculate what is dr by dt from this expression and put it here to get the value of N2. So writing this expression as 2m omega, V is dr by dt. So we are differentiating r, we get r by 4 into e power omega t, differentiation is e power omega t into omega, plus e power minus omega t into minus omega. So we get the value of N2 as mr omega square by 2 into e power omega t minus e power minus omega t. The net reaction force on the block due to disc is N2 j cap plus N1 k cap. So N2 j cap plus N1 k cap is the net reaction force on the block due to the disc. So let us just write down the final expression. So the net reaction force on the block is mr omega square by 2 into e power omega t minus e power minus omega t j cap plus mg into k cap. The method which I had discussed with you till now is the standard method to solve the problem and get the correct answers. Now let us say you are in the exam and you have very less time. You would have seen the question took quite some time to solve. With practice, you can solve it faster. Okay. So if you have very less time and you want to achieve maximum marks, what could you do so that you can extract maximum marks from the question? So I'm putting here a snapshot of the JEE 2016 question, which we had discussed. And I want you to see that, you know, there is a little lengthy paragraph here, and you might have to go through this paragraph, then analyze all this and then solve the equations to get to the right answer. Let us see how can we mark the correct options by observation. So one thing that you know is that this disc is going around. Okay, you have very less time, you have just gone through the question, and you have seen that the block is here, the disc is going around, and this block moves outside like this. Okay, so a mental picture you can get that is if the disk is continuously rotating in this direction, the block will keep moving outside. Okay, so if the block keeps moving outside, this R you see there right here, the R will always increase with time, right? So if you examine the options here, the option A, if you see, it is e power time, so this is always increasing, right? The next option is cos omega t, so we know that this is not always increasing, so we can eliminate option B. Next, we have option C, and C is also e power time, so this is also continuously increasing. So we could have C as a correct option. Next, the option D, it is not continuously increasing, so we can eliminate option D. So B and D are eliminated, we have only option A and C. So we come to a conclusion that question number 15, either A or C is correct. Let us move on to question number 16. Again, you observe all the options. Okay, we have mg k cap, mg k cap, minus mg k cap, and minus mg k cap. We know that mg is acting downwards, so normal reaction is upwards. So normal reaction magnitude is mg and its direction is k cap. So one reaction on the block must be mg into k cap. So we can say for the 16th question, either A or B is the correct answer because it has plus mg into k cap. So for 16th question, A or B could be correct. Now, as the reaction on the disk, okay, due to the block is a function of V, right, is a function of V, and V is nothing but dr by dt. Right, V is nothing but dr by dt. What we can say is, if 15th one the option is A, then 16th one the option must be B. You examine this, we have e power omega t plus e power minus omega t, and in B option we have e power omega t minus e power minus omega t. So if you differentiate this, you will get this. So either we can have A and B correct, or if C is correct, then option A is correct. So if question 15 C is correct, then question 16 A must be correct. Either A and B are correct, or C and A are correct. It was given in the exam that each of the question is plus 3 marks for correct answer or 0 marks for the wrong answer. Now, as we know that if option A is right, then B will be right, we can keep option A and B, and actually the answers were A and B, you would have got 3 plus 3 marks, which is 6 marks, right? So this is a risky option. Either you could put A or B or C and A. Why C and A? C has e power 2 omega t and A also has e power 2 omega t. So it could be either be A and B or C and A, but this could be a risky choice because in one case you will get full marks, but in the other case you would lose all the marks and you will get 0 marks. Okay, let us consider another case which is a safe bet. That is, if you keep A here and A here, so here e power omega t and e power 2 omega t, you are sure one of them would be the correct answer, right? So what would happen is, you can either keep A and A. So one option is either to keep A and A. You are covering e power omega t and e power 2 omega t if you keep A and A, or C and B. So C, it is e power 2 omega t, and B is e power omega t. So in either of the cases, one will be wrong and the other will be correct, and you'll be left with 3 marks or 3 marks, right? So in these 4 options, these two are the similar option. In these 4 options, you can see, and if you have very less time, based on this, you can keep an answer and extract the maximum marks possible from the question. So I hope you are able to understand completely the GE 2016 question, how to solve it properly, methodologically, and second thing, if you do not have time, how to extract the maximum marks from it. If you like the video, you have benefited from it, do like, share, and subscribe.